Hello, my name is Barnabas and I would like to make a 1 hour video session about drawing. I'm going to draw random stuff, probably humans or all kind of shapes, so whatever comes to mind. I don't have any specific plan for what I'm going to draw. I'm doing this because my drawing skills currently are not great. They're pretty bad, so I would like to improve them as fast as I can, and I think a good way to do it is to record it and put it on YouTube, and I don't know, maybe if anyone is interested, maybe can also give suggestions what to draw next time in comments or well, if you have any ideas, you know. What I'm going to draw is today is some sort of architectural form. I don't have any specific in mind, something based on a cube or cubes or rectangular shapes, whatever. It's going to be 1 hour, yep. So let's get started, I would say. Sorry for the video quality, it sucks at the moment. This is the equipment I have right now, so wanted to get started, so I'm gonna use this now, but I will upgrade the equipment soon. Alright. So, I don't know how good is this going to be. Maybe it's not even visible, but I have this timer here, starting the 1 hour. Alright, so let's see, is it even visible, this very thin lines, not sure if they are visible at all. Are they? Yeah, they are. Alright, well, let's see. So I guess I'm just gonna draw horizon line, let's say. Well, which is already not horizontal, so that's what I'm talking about. This has to improve. So this will probably be some sort of abstract architecture, let's say. Alright, another rectangle here. So if the drawings will be good enough at some point, then the plan is that I'm going to set up an Etsy shop, and then I don't know, if anybody likes it, then can buy it there. Okay. Let's see. So these are free-floating boxes. Perspective here is not good. Okay, let's say they stand in nothing on pillars. Well, this is way too big, this one. Yeah, it's very hard. Drawing is always a challenge. In the end, it would be nice to figure out how the shadows are being cast on these three objects, so I'm not gonna make it too complicated, otherwise it, the shadows would take forever to figure out. Okay, so three platforms kind of standing on these pillars, so maybe an arc would be nice. It would be an arcs. Like that. And their one as well. Okay. An arc here as well. So maybe an arc needs a line that, a constructive line. Okay, there one. So how is this? It's kind of like this, yeah. Should be thick, whatever. That doesn't have to be thicker, it's alright. Okay. So, and back. Well, that we don't see at all, so that's alright. This one we don't see either, because it's. This guy covers it in the back. Alright, well then let's move on to this one. Let's try to draw a horizontal line, which is a vertical line, I mean. Super hard. Okay. I don't know how entertaining this will be. Probably zero entertainment, but I don't know if it's. Some people like to see how a drawing is made. Okay, so this is in front of that, and is it? Yeah, it is, and this one is going to be about like standing on top of the other platform around here. This leg is just standing in infinity. Okay, so these arcs have to continue all around the shape. Back. Wow, I have no idea how is this one. So there, it comes from there till there, and the top is there. Okay. It's a bit messy here now, which I hate when it's messy. Okay, so this one and this one, how they relate to each other, that's clear, but this guy is also standing on top of this one, but a little bit And then this leg then also stands on top of that, but why would it stand there? So we will just make a trick and make it look like as if it wouldn't stand there, so it might be interesting to look at, because it's gonna make your mind wander, or your brain confused. Who's standing on top of whom? Who's front on? Who's behind? Okay, so if we wait, still have to finish this in the back. Okay. So far, yeah, I don't like that, for example, this platform, or I don't know what is this, like, tower, is exactly and almost in the same line as this other tower. That makes it look way less interesting than if it would overlap, if it would go inside, for example. So maybe that's something to just do, like, for example, like that. That would be way better. So let's do that. Yeah, that's again pretty bad, because obviously this should be the top of the arc, should be this line, so makes more sense. Okay. There is the back leg, the leg in behind, and the back. In behind. Yeah, my English is also, like, needs some work. Sorry about that. Okay, there. Yeah, that, there, and there. So I can finally draw this curve, this arc here. I mean, there. Something like that. Okay. So now I look at it from the top and I can see that these lines are not vertical. So that's a big problem. Which, yeah, I just have to fix these guys here. Yep, and this continues down here. Okay, well, that's better. Of course, this should be higher, like this one should go up till here. It would make it more interesting. I don't know, composition would be better as well. Not just, doesn't just make it interesting for no reason. Then, because then there is a hierarchy as well. Okay, how much time do I have? Because maybe I should start working on the shadows. Yeah. Some details would be nice. Because now this top platform, so the top of the towers are quite plain. Maybe what I could do is to add, well, I could do anything, but what I was thinking to do is to just add some plus sign into them. So then, when this comes down, this leg, this pillar, then, well, that will stand in exactly inside this. gap. Right. Why not? Usually I listen music when I draw, not always. But lately I found that if I don't listen anything, I just like it more. Okay. Here, and here we can add the detail, ornament detail, which is just a recess. Not too much. Okay, let's figure out the shadows. That's the exciting part. Wow, these are so not vertical. It's unbelievable. Well, this is the reason. This is the goal of this whole exercise too. Like, be able to draw a horizontal or vertical line, which is not much to ask, but I can't even do that, so. You would have a light, like a hard light, coming from this angle. It should be like, more like this. From behind, so these faces would be in the shadow, this completely in the shadow, except this. And then, like, maybe this is too sharp, this angle, maybe it has to be like 45 degree. Kind of. Yeah, maybe that's better. I don't know. So this is the part which is like, yeah, it's quite challenging. It's hard to imagine for me sometimes, like how these shadows will be. It's coming from behind and then. Of course, we're playing a trick here as well with the perspective, which doesn't help either. But yeah, let's try. So this guy will cast a shadow on, yeah, something like that. More like this. And then, of course, it's like a leg, I mean a pillar, and have the arc. If the arc would be like projected onto this surface there, then it would be something like this, I would imagine. something like this. And then on the side it would be, how would it be on the side? Just vertical line. This would be making a shadow like that. That would, this guy would be something like this. This casts a shadow which is going this way. I mean a bit for this leg casts another shadow. And that leg in the back doesn't cast anything. But this is already a shadow, so this is only relevant here in this part. Breaks down, of course. So how are we going to do the shadows? Graphite, I would say. I'll do just graphite tones. Because this is something I'm really not good at, making shadows or like darker tones. I think it just requires a technique that, yeah, I just don't know. I didn't practice enough, and like now I'm making these darker lines, and that already completely destroys the. Well, not completely, but it's like kind of a disappointing result. So here the shadow is like that. What is that? That's a shadow. same value should go here. Which is, of course, pretty difficult. Hole inside is also the same value. So I'm just giving, trying to give all the shadows the same value. And in the end, maybe make highlights with the eraser. Okay. So boring to make all these the same color, same value. It's all the same value, why was I... Well... Okay... Alright, so is this... This is probably also in... Yeah, definitely in shadow, so... Also needs the same value. Maybe just different direction of lines, but... Doesn't matter. Okay, so now we're gonna make outlines, I guess. I would call them outlines with ink. Yeah, let's try this one. I'm not sure if it's a good idea. Yeah, it is a good idea. because this is going to make it clear what how the lines are, who's fronting whom. Yeah, and this also makes it obvious when I make a bad line. So for example, this one should be like that. Well, because this one goes through this arc. These are the internal corners. So I can say it's this high. It's almost like a rambling, but with drawing. Think about it like that. Ramblings with a pencil. kind of things are. I never liked them. And, like, this edge is continuing exactly, falls into the same line exactly as the edge behind it. Just makes it look weird. Yeah, this one probably should be more fat there. Yep. Okay. So now let's make some highlights. Maybe I should use charcoal for these shadows. Do some erasing. Well, I hope I'm recording this because I'm not gonna do it again. At least not today. I was wondering if, like, this casts a shadow on its own leg, most probably, so this also should be a shadow. And this leg, which is the hypothetical leg, That's not really a hypothetical, it's a leg. So that's alright. So let's cast shadow there. And then it's here, there is no shadow. Alright, so three towers with arches, casting shadows, and we still have 10 minutes. In those 10 minutes, I will find a way to make this more a better drawing. It would be probably if I would give some hard edges, thicker edges probably would help. Let's do this with another ink. Okay, if I would use this here. These are the moments when I can fuck up the whole thing. I would imagine these are the darkest corners. So let's give them strong accent. It's in front. Yeah, this can also have. Yeah, I think it's good. And consider this finished. Some background would be nice. Just maybe just some suggestion of a background. But, yeah. This point, I think I will finish it as it is. Maybe it would be nice to give stronger shadows here. Does it help? I don't think so. It's weird. Alright, well, here you go. The three arcs. Tower of the three arcs. The tallest one is the highest in the hierarchy. Therefore, it has a distinctive quality of an ornament on it. The most elite arc from these ones, at least. The lowest has a plus sign, for no reason really. See you next time. I think time is almost up actually. Well, 1 minute, half, 1.5 minutes. So, 1.5 minutes. What can I do in 1.5 minutes? Make this background suggestion? Alright. Does that help? I don't know. What would be the background for this? I mean, maybe the background could be just like enormous, the suggestion of some enormous structures in the back. Like this. And then one like that. Of course it has to break down here. And then it comes down all the way till here. Okay, time is up now, but now I have to continue a little bit longer because now I already started on this background suggestion. So let's just do those two, because then this needs shadow, some subtle shadow, which I can, I'm not sure if I can do a subtle shadow, so my technique is rusty. And that would mean the light shines upon this surface here. can get rid of the graphite from there. So this is not a very creative drawing, of course. Eventually I would like to turn it into more creative drawing. It's just... I have to be able to draw faster. To be able to make something complex or more interesting. This amount of time. So that's one cube, and the other one is here. Alright, well, that's it. So, let's see. This is drawing number one. See you next time, which is probably going to be tomorrow.